Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. Although we don't show real body parts in this video, we show an image of how an eye works. Viewers who are sensitive to the light sciences should have an adult view this first to be sure it's suitable for that viewer. This is a somewhat advanced video that builds on prior knowledge. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you first watch the videos on colors of light, light transmission, light reflection, and energy forms before watching this video. On a clear day, we can see many vibrant colors and objects far away. But underwater, colors seem mostly dark blue and gray. And our visibility may be only a few hundred feet at best. But if we use a flashlight, then we can see full colors at any depth. All of these experiences can be explained by light absorption. Understanding light absorption is also important in knowing how to protect ourselves around lasers and how to make the most of some technologies. In this video, we'll introduce concepts related to light absorption, including what light is absorbed by opaque, solid objects, what light is absorbed by transparent, solid objects, what light is absorbed by transparent liquids, and what happens to absorbed light. We'll start by looking at what light is absorbed by opaque, solid objects. This battery case has a black and red wire. When we shine a red light on it, the red wire looks red. But when we shine a blue light or a green light on the case, then the red wire looks almost as black as the black wire. Why does the red wire appear to be changing colors? The reason is because red objects reflect red light well, so when we shine red light on them, we'll see red light that comes into our eyes. In contrast, red objects absorb other colors of light, including blue and green. So when we shine those colors on them, no light is reflected into our eyes, so they look black. Black is the color we perceive when there's no light coming into our eyes. White light contains about 400 unique light colors, but for simplicity, we'll just draw red, blue, and green light colors coming from a white light flashlight. The red light that's part of the white light reflects off a red object, then comes into our eyes. So, we see the object as being red when we're using white light. This same observation applies to other colors too. For example, this blue lid looks almost black under green light and under red light. But under white light and blue light, the lid looks blue. That's because a blue object reflects blue light, but a blue object absorbs other colors of light such as red and green. Likewise, this green leaf looks almost black under blue light and under red light. But under white light and green light, the leaf looks green. That's because a green object reflects green light. But a green object absorbs other colors of light, such as blue light and red light. Next, let's look at what light is absorbed by transparent solid objects. Which of these safety glasses would not protect you from the glare of a red laser? The red safety glasses would give you no protection because the red light easily transmits through the glasses. In contrast, the red light barely transmits through the blue glasses because the blue glasses absorb all colors except for blue. When something is transparent and has a color, we call it a filter. A filter will transmit light that is the color of the filter, but that filter will absorb other light colors. Here's a blue filter. It transmits blue light easily, but it absorbs red light, so no red light is transmitted. Since white light contains some blue light, that blue light transmits through the blue filter. Stained glass windows are also filters. This green filter transmits green light well, but it absorbs violet light. Next, we'll look at what light is absorbed by transparent liquids. We'll shine a violet, green, and red laser into common liquid soaps. Which laser light will go the farthest in this orange soap? Orange is close to the red end of the spectrum, so orange liquid transmits red light well. Green light is totally absorbed after a few centimeters, and violet light is absorbed after only a few millimeters. Transparent liquids behave the same as transparent solids that have a color. Both are light filters. They transmit light colors that are very similar to their own color, but they absorb light colors that are different than their color. Now we're ready to understand why all colors seem blue, gray, or black deep underwater, and why it gets darker as we go farther below the ocean's surface. Water is blue, so it transmits blue light well but absorbs other colors of light. At only 25 feet below the ocean's surface, there's almost no red light left since it has been absorbed by the first 25 feet of water. Soon after that, other colors of light are also absorbed. Although blue light transmits the best, it's also being absorbed. And by 700 feet below the ocean's surface, there's very little light that has made it through. At even deeper levels, it is like midnight all the time. This means that red fish that are 25 feet below the ocean's surface will look black, because there is no red light to reflect off their bodies. But when a diver shines white light on them, that white light contains red light, which will reflect off their bodies, so we can see the fish are red. Next, we'll look at what happens to light energy after it's been absorbed by something. In the video on energy forms and conversions, we learned about 6 common forms of energy. We also learned that energy can easily change from one of these energy forms to another energy form in a process called energy conversion. Another phrase for the process of changing energy forms is called energy transformations. Absorbed light energy is commonly converted into 3 other forms of energy: heat energy, electrical energy, and chemical energy. We'll give several examples of each of these energy conversions. We'll start by looking at light energy being converted to heat energy. When this wood absorbs light energy, the wood converts the light energy into heat energy. The wood gets so hot that the wood instantly vaporizes into smoke and leaves a space where the wood was. That space creates a deep cut around the wood. Lasers can cut materials because those materials convert the laser's light energy into heat energy. When ink, paint, or dyes absorb light energy, they convert that light energy into heat energy. Darker papers absorb a lot of light compared with lighter colors, so they are converting more light energy into heat energy, which explains why darker colors are hotter than lighter colors. White reflects all light colors, so it absorbs no light energy. That's why we often wear white clothes as a way to stay cool on hot days. In contrast, black reflects no light, so it absorbs all light colors. After absorbing all light colors, this paint converts that light energy into heat energy. Next, we'll look at how light energy is converted to electrical energy. Solar cells convert light energy into electrical energy. The more light energy they absorb, the more electrical energy they give. Some solar panels and arrays are so big that they can power many homes. Before giving examples of how light energy converts to chemical energy, let's review what chemical energy is. Each drop of water dripping into this glass has billions and billions of molecules. Each molecule is too tiny for us to see, but each one has a shape like this model. A molecule of water is made of 1 atom of oxygen and 2 atoms of hydrogen. That's why scientists call water H2O. These sticks represent connections holding the atoms together. We call these bonds. When we're talking about chemical energy, we're usually referring to the energy stored in chemical bonds. A chemical reaction can break, change, or make chemical bonds. Here's an example of a chemical reaction that breaks bonds, and the energy to drive that chemical reaction came from absorbed light energy. We left a part of this paper in the sun for a few weeks. That chemical reaction broke the dye molecules apart. So the part of the paper that was exposed to light is now much paler than the part of the paper that was covered and didn't get any light. Here's an example of a chemical reaction that's driven by absorbed light energy. When light goes into an eye, it lands on the back of the eye called the retina. The retina then sends an electrical signal to the brain, telling it what color light came into the eye and where it landed, so the brain knows what object may be close. There are many steps in this process, but the first step is when this tiny molecule changes this bond. So the molecule changes from this bent position to this straight position. The energy to drive this chemical reaction came from absorbed light energy. Here's an example of absorbed light being converted into chemical energy that makes bonds. This is a magnified view of a plant leaf showing many plant cells. The green balls inside the cells contain a molecule called chlorophyll. Chlorophyll absorbs light energy, and that energy drives the chemical reaction to make bonds, which form sugar molecules. The plants then use that sugar to make stems, leaves, and fruits. We call this process photosynthesis. Here's a summary of this topic and some extra information. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Thanks for your attention.